So are you thinking about moving to Sacramento, California and looking for a great area to raise a family that's safe and where you can get a lot of bang for your buck? Well, I have the perfect spot. Hi, this is Jacqueline Gage and this is SacEngage, where we talk about everything living in Sacramento. So if that's something you're interested in, please subscribe to my channel. All right, today we're going to talk to you about the city of Roseville. It's an awesome place to raise a family, very safe. A lot of people in the past 20 years have been moving here from the Bay Area, and it also has local Sacramento residents, and it's become quite a popular spot and grown tremendously in the last 10 years. So let's get down to some details about Roseville. Roseville is the largest city in Placer County, and it has a population of about 139,000 people. In the last 10 years, it's increased tremendously. In comparison to Sacramento, it's about 22 miles from downtown. Depending on traffic, it could take you 30 to 45 minutes. And if you need to get to the airport, that's gonna be 26 miles away. And that could, I would say, give yourself a good 45 minutes. So just a little trivia fact about Roseville. It is the city that survived 7,000 bombs in a shipping accident during the Vietnam era. So I would say any city that can survive that is pretty resilient and may be a great place to consider. So let's talk about the vibe of Roseville, because when you choose some place to live, you really gotta vibe and jive with it. So Roseville, even though it has a historic area, is predominantly newer. There's a lot of subdivisions. A lot of people move outside of Sacramento when they want to expand their home. They're having a bigger family. You can get a lot of house for an average price point. And there is, you know, it doesn't have a big walkability factor, but everything that you need is about 10 minutes away. Like any store you could imagine, lots of big chain stores, a lot of shopping malls, shopping plazas, and it's really clean. The streets are paved, no potholes, unlike in Sacramento where there's a ton, and there's no homeless, rarely any. So it has a really nice, clean, safe environment that is newer and all uniforms, I'd say. If you want a more in-depth look about the demographics and lifestyle of Roseville, a great website I came upon is Esri.com, which breaks down any zip code in the US. You just put it in and they can give you all these demographics and stats, like median age, median income, and it's a great way to tell if an area suits you. Okay guys, so let's talk about the cost of living in Roseville, because when you're determining a place to live, that's really important. So the average price point of a home in Roseville is going to run you $494,000, so just shy of $500,000. And a home of that price point is going to look like this. You'll see you get a lot newer of a home as compared to Sacramento and a lot more square footage. So when we compare price per square foot, Roseville is $242 price per square foot, and Sacramento is going to be about $246. So, you know, if a larger home, newer, is important to you with, you know, an area with great schools, Roseville would be a great place to consider. Also, if you're thinking about renting, an average one bedroom is going to be around $1,300 a month. Now, that's going to be give or take depending on where you live in Roseville and the upgrades in the apartment. But you can get, you know, a nice one bedroom for $1,300 a month. All right, so I always like to talk about the cost of living somewhere as it relates to the cost of living index, because it's a good indicator where it lies in comparison to other places. So the national average is 100, and in California, the cost of living index is 140, and Roseville's cost of living is 133. So it's definitely lower than most areas in California, and like I said, a lot of bang for your buck. All right, so let's talk about Roseville and recreational activities. There is a ton of stuff to do. In fact, another cool trivia fact for you, Roseville was ranked number 11 out of 25 US cities in all across the nation as one of the healthiest cities to live in, number 11. So that is a true testimony to the lifestyle of Roseville. I mean, it's really easy to be active. There's lots of hiking trails and parks. One such park is Madu Regional Park. I mean, you gotta check it out. It's not your normal park with a jungle gym and some grass and a picnic table. No, it has over 150 acres and there's literally everything there you can imagine. Your kids will absolutely love it, so put it on the checklist, but just to name a few, you have a soccer complex, softball complex, basketball court, rose garden, library, community center. I mean, it has everything. And then, you know, hiking, biking, walking, you wanna go on one of the trails. There's Miner's Ravine Trail, which is an awesome one. And also, if you're a golfer, tons of golf in Roseville. In fact, some of the golf courses have housing communities around them. So really great active lifestyle in Roseville, easy to get into, a lot of activities, and great weather for it. All right, so schools. As far as schools, Roseville has a lot of great schools. One website I recommend you checking out and get the details of specific schools is greatschools.org. Awesome website. And then as far as employment, which is another thing to consider, a lot of people commute from Roseville to Sacramento. Some even go Roseville to the Bay Area. But just within Roseville, Kaiser Permanente is a big employer, as well as Hewlett Packard and Union Pacific Railroad. So those are the top three. So a safe place to live is very important, and Roseville has just that. In fact, Business Insider ranked it number 21 out of 25 top cities in the US for safest cities. So that's an awesome ranking and something really to be proud about. Most of the crimes are just like petty crimes, and in fact, Roseville's crime rate is less than half that of the average in California. All right, so let's talk about places to eat. Like I said, Roseville has everything at your fingertips within a 10-minute drive, and they have every chain you could imagine. One of my favorites is Paul Martin's. I love it. It has American cuisine, really nice vibe, little upscale, great cocktails. And one that is more mom and pop would be House of Oliver. Really cool, a lot of charm. It's a wine lounge and restaurant. And on the weekends, they have music, so check that out. All right, so besides the recreation, there are endless things to do in Roseville. Something for everyone in the family. Like, let's talk about Topgolf, super fun. You don't even have to golf to play. And then there's iFly, indoor skydiving. I'm still too chicken to do that. And then there's Golfland Sunsplash for the little kiddos. They will love that. Amusement park, have everything there, miniature golf course. The American Park Speedway, NASCAR Speedway. So if you want action-packed entertainment, that's the spot. And if you are like an antique person or love the farmer's market, Denio's is a great spot. It's a farmer's market and swap meet, been there forever. And then the Antique Trove, I love going and finding new pieces. It's a cool place to scavenger hunt for something perfect for the home. So those are a few of the things that I would recommend checking out in Roseville. So now I can't forget one of the best things to do, and that is shopping. And boy, does Roseville have the shopping. In fact, people from Sacramento go to Roseville to shop because they have a lot more inventory and choices. Roseville is 13th in all of California cities for top retail sales. So really, retail is a vital part of Roseville. And a couple places you're gonna check out and you'll know about them when you go to Roseville are the Fountains. It's an awesome outdoor Galleria shopping mall, and it's really upscale. There's something to do for the whole family. You have the choo-choo train, the kids love that. And the big thing is the fountains actually change color and they go to the music changes as well. So it's a little light show. And then there's the Roseville Galleria, which is really nice. It's an indoor shopping plaza, and that's just like right across the street. So you have everything in one strip. I mean, you can just shop till you drop and explore all the shops in Roseville. Okay, so one of the last things I recommend you doing in Roseville is checking out the downtown historic Roseville. It's really old and charming. There's lots to do, and the fact in recent years we've had some growth and expansion. A lot of community events are happening. In fact, there was just a mural project where local artists painted murals in the downtown area. And in fact, Sacramento is a big mural city in general. We have one contest every year. And one event to check out is Tuesday nights downtown, because there's live bands and vendors and lots of stuff to do. And that's every Tuesday night during the summer. All right, I hope you found this video on Roseville, California informative. It is an awesome spot to live, very family friendly, great schools, low crime, and new homes, and you can get a lot of bang for your buck. So if you have any questions about the area, please message me. I'm a local realtor, and if you have any questions about Sacramento in general, please give me a call. I'd love to help you, and this is Living in Sacramento, so don't forget to subscribe down below so you can watch other videos and are notified. All right, until next time, take care.